my channel. My name's Cassie if you guys are new here. So in today's video, it's gonna be a little bit different. Usually I do vlogs, but today I'm gonna do a sit-down video and I'm gonna be talking all about YouTube. So I asked you guys on my Instagram story, I'll pop it up here, video recommendations you wanted to see, and surprisingly a lot of people were interested and curious about how I started YouTube, why I started YouTube, and resources that I use, camera that I use, editing software, music, websites, things like that. So I thought it'd be interesting to discuss with you guys all of those things and also give you some tips for beginners, because I know when I was starting YouTube, I was watching all the videos in the world, tips for beginners, and just trying to learn as much as I could when I was starting. So I hope this video will be helpful to you guys if you are thinking about maybe starting your own channel, you've been dabbling with it, but you're not really sure. I really hope this video is helpful and informative and can just give you some tips when starting your channel. If you're new here, like I said, my name is Cassie. Thank you for clicking on this video. Don't forget to subscribe. I upload every single Tuesday and Friday. But without further ado, let's get started. So when I first started YouTube, it was definitely a whole new world to me. But surprisingly, I learned everything that I know from YouTube. So many creators out there have so many videos and resources that can really help you, especially for beginners, just tips and different cameras to use, the best cameras for vlogging, different editing softwares, different websites for music. So many things are out there on the internet. You really just have to take advantage of them, but there's so much information, there's so many resources. So I'll kind of point out to you guys the ones that I specifically used and what really helped me start my channel. Okay, first things first, I'm gonna talk about the camera that I'm currently using. So when I first started my channel, I actually used a camera that I had already had. My parents bought me a Canon G12 years ago. It was really, really old, but it actually had an option for recording. So it was perfect for vlogging, and there was no reason why I couldn't start because I already had the camera. So I literally just picked up the camera one day and started filming. I already had that camera, which was really helpful, but then I noticed the quality wasn't the best, and I really wanted to like level up my videos. Once I really decided that I really loved YouTube, it was a passion of mine, I really enjoyed it, I decided to invest in a better camera, and I did a lot of research on what cameras were the best for vlogging. I didn't want to spend a fortune on a camera just because this is more of like a hobby to me. Of course, I'd love to pursue it one day, but I didn't really want to spend like $2,000-$3,000 on a camera. So I decided to go with the Canon G7X Mark II. I read so many different articles, I watched so many different videos, so many people use this camera. I know it's like the number one vlogging camera, but it really is a great camera. The picture is awesome. It's super easy to use, super, super user friendly. For somebody who is not really sure how to use a camera, this one, you literally just pick it up and start recording. It's so easy. And I sometimes will take photos with it too. Eventually, I would like to get a better camera in terms of content, like when I'm taking photos and like food photography and things like that. I would like to get a camera that's more designated for that and specific to pictures. But for now, I'm using my G7X Mark II and I love it. So I can't recommend this camera enough. If you're starting out on your channel, or maybe you're looking for a new camera but you don't wanna like really break the bank, this one I think I got for about $500, which I know can sound like a lot, but in comparison to a lot of the other cameras on the market, I felt like this one was really good with the quality. I felt like it wasn't too expensive. A lot of other cameras in the market are super, super expensive, and I do think it's an investment. I've had it for, say, 6 to 7 months now, and I love it. I'm so happy with it. It's super easy to use, super user friendly, and there's a lot of different things you can do with it. Things that I don't even know yet. I literally just pick it up and start filming, but I know that there's a lot that you can do with it. So I really do want to learn more about this camera, but this is the one I currently use now, Canon G7X Mark II, and I love it. Okay, editing software. This was a big one that I was trying to decide what I wanted to use. So I started with iMovie because I have a Mac, it was free, it was super easy to use, and I didn't really need to watch any videos because I've used iMovie in the past when I used to create videos when I was younger. So I literally just started using iMovie. It's a great software to use, super easy to use, it's user friendly, just like the camera, but it's also nice because it's already on your computer. So if you have a Mac, it's installed onto your computer. There's really no necessary things that you have to do besides just use it. If you're unfamiliar in how to use it, there's so many YouTube videos on there, but I started with iMovie, I loved it. But there came a time where I felt like I kind of graduated from iMovie, so I decided to get Final Cut Pro, and it's nice because they actually had a free 90-day trial where you could use it and see if you liked it. So I did that, I absolutely loved it. There's just more features that you can do. You can do more overlays. It just offers a little bit more. There's so many videos out there that really compare the two between iMovie and Final Cut Pro and the comparisons, the similarities, things like that. So I watched a ton of those before making the investment because it is quite expensive. I think it's $2.99 to buy the software. nowhere, but I love it. I think it's definitely worth the investment. But if you're just starting out on your channel, I would recommend starting with iMovie, because YouTube is definitely something where you have to stay super consistent and it does require a lot of time and a lot of work. So I would hate for you to spend $299 on a software and then not want to use it, you know? So I do think that they do have some sort of like a trial where you can try out the software, see if you like it. That's what I did, and I felt like it was really great to do that because I wasn't spending $300 right off the bat. But once I really got comfortable with the software, I learned so many different things that you could do with it with several videos that I watched. I felt it was worth the investment, and I really love using Final Cut Pro now. I don't use iMovie anymore, but I would recommend that if you are just starting out. Okay, so like I mentioned before, when I started my channel, I literally learned everything that I know now from watching YouTubers. So a few creators that I felt provided a lot of resources and value when starting my channel. Natalie Barbu is the first one. I watched tons of her videos. She talks all about starting your channel. She talks a lot about the analytics of YouTube. She gives really great tips and tricks, so I really loved watching hers. She also has a video where she talks about Final Cut Pro and how she edits and softwares that she uses and different websites. So I really liked watching her and learning from her because she provided a lot of tips that made it easier when starting your channel. Natalie Barbu is somebody I watched. Catherine Manning is also somebody else who I watched. So she used to be known as the Content Bug, but I believe she switched over her channel name to just her name, Catherine Manning. She is so, so, so knowledgeable when it comes to YouTube. She knows everything about the algorithm. She talks all about her channel. She's super transparent with her analytics, and she talks all about how to start a channel, how to become monetized. She is a wealth of knowledge when it comes to YouTube. She provides so much value, and I learned so much from her. So I will link her channel, I'll link Natalie's channel, and there's another creator I want to talk about too. But Catherine really helped me when I started my channel, and I still watch her videos to this day because she's super transparent with things. She talks all about YouTube, starting your channel, what you need to know, little secrets about YouTube. She's great. So she's one I definitely loved watching. And then when it came to learning all about Final Cut Pro, I was watching Mark Harrison on YouTube. So he has a really cool channel. He has a bunch of different things that he talks about, but the videos that I really loved watching from him were all about the Final Cut Pro software. So he talks all about transitions. He talks about like hidden hacks in Final Cut Pro, how to use Final Cut Pro, Final Cut Pro for beginners. He really lays it out nicely where it's super easy to learn and use. The nice thing about Final Cut Pro is there's so many different things that you can do on it, but you don't have to take advantage of everything if you feel overwhelmed. Like when I first started, I literally did the bare minimum with it. And once I got the hang of those things, I learned more. So many different resources out there that can help you learn how to navigate the program because it is quite confusing. There's a lot that goes on to it, but I do think it's user-friendly once you get the hang of it. But he has really great tutorials when learning all about the software and just how to get comfortable with it and start using it and all the different things that you can do with Final Cut Pro. So I would recommend looking at him as well if you're thinking about leaving iMovie if you're using that, or maybe a different software and you're trying to dabble into Final Cut Pro. Watch his videos. He has really great, awesome tips and tricks and just really compares a lot of the softwares with Final Cut. So I really loved watching him too. Okay, so music. This is something I was super conscious about, I guess, because I didn't want to get copyrighted when it comes to music. I've watched a ton of videos and so many people say like the copyright bans are real. So you definitely don't want to get copyrighted on your videos because then you can't put ads on there, I think. Anyways, when I first started, I used Thematic. I believe that is the website. It's a free website. They have really great music. I really liked using them, but I wasn't crazy about how you had to put the actual URL in the description of your video. I don't know, I just felt like I was a little bit limited with the website, but I do think it's a great free website and they have so many different music options on there. So I did use that to start, and then I eventually switched to Epidemic Sound. I think I might pay like $9 or $11 a month for that. There is a subscription to it, but I think it's worth it. They have a huge music selection. They also have tons of different sound effects that you can use. I really love using Epidemic Sound. And the other cool thing that I really like about it is there's a lot of songs that I have like listened to in the past that are on there with no copyright issues, obviously. So as long as you have a subscription with the company, like you're fine, you're not gonna get copyrighted. But that is the platform or like music that I use, Epidemic Sound. I really like it. They have great music, great sound effects, and super easy to use as well. You literally just download it. It goes right into your iTunes library, and then from there you can pull it into Final Cut. Okay, let's talk about thumbnails. Everybody's favorite, because these are just like what you see before you click on the video. Aesthetics, I'm all about that. So I create my thumbnails on PicMonkey. I know there's so many different resources services and websites that you can use to create thumbnails, but I stumbled across this right when I started and I honestly have just been using it ever since. I have no complaints with it. I love it. That is something I do pay monthly for as well. I don't remember how much it is. It's not expensive at all. I think it's like $5 or $10. I can't really remember, but it's a really easy website to use to create your thumbnails. You can also create so many other things with there too. Like you can create Instagram stories, Instagram posts, different graphics. There's so much you can do with PicMonkey. I love it. It's a great resource for like creativity and just like content creation as a whole. So I've been using that ever since I started. That's how I create my thumbnails. Super easy. I love that platform. You can also add your own fonts to it. You can upload your own pictures, things like that. So if you're looking to start off on YouTube and you're not sure how to create a thumbnail, definitely try PicMonkey. I think they do have a free trial as well. That's what I used. And once I decided that I liked it, I decided to become a member, but you can cancel it anytime. I really love it. And that's how I create my thumbnails. Okay, now moving on to some tips when starting YouTube. These are some that I found through different creators that they had recommended and also some that I've just learned along the way. So my first tip is to make sure that your videos are not super long, but not too short. I think anywhere after 10 minutes is pretty good, but anywhere over 30 minutes, I feel like it's a little bit long. A lot of people recommended to make your videos longer because then more people are watching your videos for a longer amount of time, which helps your watch hours, which helps you to get monetized. So that's something that I learned, I think, from Katherine Manning. She recommended that. And through every vlog, I try to make them for over 10 minutes. That way I get more watch hours. And I think it just provides a little bit more content for people to watch and just a little bit more of like the creativity aspect. So you definitely want to make sure your videos are not too short, because if your videos are too short, it will be harder and take much longer for you to become monetized. So to become monetized, you need 1,000 subscribers on YouTube and 4,000 watch hours, which might not sound like a lot, but it is. But I will say, if you make your videos a little bit longer, it helps to get you there a little bit quicker. Another tip that literally everybody said, and I do agree with it, is find your niche. So when starting YouTube, I think it can be kind of overwhelming because you don't know what you want to talk about. You don't know what your channel is going to be, like the vibe. Are you going to make more vlogs? Are you going to be more sit down? I think it's good to figure out your niche and kind of stick with it, because then the people that are watching you, subscribe to you, can really follow along and make sure that they're coming to your page for that specific reason. So I would say my channel is a little bit more like health, wellness, fitness, and lifestyle. That's kind of what my whole channel encompasses. And those are the things that I've tried to stay true to ever since starting my channel. That is my niche, and the people who I'm connecting with and the people who are watching my videos can come to my videos and know that is the content and the value that they're gonna be getting when watching videos. So I would definitely recommend to try to find your niche, and this comes with trial and error too. Like, you might think you will start your channel for like sit down videos or vlogs and then realize you hate doing one of those things and maybe you like to do something else. So I definitely do think it comes with trial and error, but I would try to think about what you're most passionate about, think about what makes you happy, and stick to making videos that will encompass those things. Another tip that I will say has helped me to grow over time and helped me to be more active on YouTube would definitely be to stay consistent. So literally every single video I watched where people were talking about how to grow on YouTube, how to become monetized quickly, they say become consistent and create a schedule of when you're gonna upload. So I've committed to uploading every single Tuesday and Friday. I've done that pretty much ever since I started that. There have been a few days where I've missed them just because things come up, but that is the schedule I put on myself. I think it just helps kind of keep me accountable and keep me on a good schedule when uploading my YouTube videos, so that way I know what days I'm filming, what days I'm editing, what days I'm uploading. So definitely try to figure out a schedule that works for you and your schedule. But if you're gonna upload one time a week, make sure you figure out, okay, on Wednesdays at 9 o'clock, I'm gonna upload. Cause I think it just helps the algorithm. It helps your followers, or your subscribers, I guess you could say, know when you're gonna upload videos. And it just helps you to stay a little bit more consistent and active on the platform. So consistency is a huge tip of mine. It's probably my number one tip. It's definitely challenging because YouTube takes a lot more time than people think. I think sometimes people just see like the final product of the video, but they don't know how much time and energy has gone into creating the video, which I'm not complaining about because I really do enjoy editing, but just having an understanding of like how much time your videos will take you and what is appropriate for you when it comes to uploading. So do you want to do one time a week, two times a week, three times a week, once every 2 weeks? I think that consistency is definitely better than kind of being sporadic, because then people who are watching you, if you're trying to grow your channel, they're not gonna know when you're gonna upload. So stick to a schedule, stick to uploading consistently, and it will help your channel grow over time. Another tip I would have would be to plan your content. So I would say I do this like 90% of the time. A lot of my videos are vlogs, but I do try to incorporate some sit-down videos and some topics that I think would be beneficial for people watching my channel. So I would definitely focus on planning your content. So if you're gonna upload, let's say you're gonna upload once a week. Maybe you're gonna say, okay, this week I'm gonna talk about, you know, do a Q&A, and next week it's gonna be a vlog, and the week after that I'm gonna like do 5 healthy recipes, or whatever your channel's about. I would focus on trying to plan some of your content, because I think sometimes if you don't have a schedule or a plan, it can be hard to stay on track and it can be hard to stay consistent. So I plan my content the majority of the time. There are some days where I just want to pick up my camera and vlog and not really think about it, and I think that's absolutely fine. But I do have a bunch of videos that I do want to film, so when I feel like I need a sit down video, I have tons of different topics that I do want to go over. So I just keep a little schedule for myself and an agenda of things that I want to plan and videos I want to create and topics I want to create, and I think that just helps me stay a little bit more organized and consistent. And then my last tip is to not overthink it. So like I said, when I started, I literally just picked up the camera that I had, but so many people have said that they've started recording and vlogging on their iPhone. People have started on their Mac. Like, don't overthink it. Don't go out and buy a $1,000 camera if you don't even know if you're gonna like vlogging or if you're gonna like YouTube, because like I said, it is very time consuming. So don't overthink it and just start. That's like one of my biggest tips, is just start. If you're thinking about starting a channel, I know there can be a lot of like excuses you're thinking of and things you're like, oh, I don't have the best equipment, and like I don't have Final Cut. Like, literally, there's so many resources out there that are free. Just start and you will learn along the way, like what your niche is and what camera you like to use and what editing software you like to use. And like I said, YouTube provides so many great tips and resources for you to learn along the way. So, and everything on there is free. So don't overthink it, just start and you will learn so much along the way. But I hope this video was helpful for you guys. I know when I was starting my channel, I literally watched every single video like this on YouTube because I had no idea where to start. So I really hope this was helpful and provided you some inspiration and value and some tips if you're thinking about starting your own channel. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, it would mean so much to me if you give this video a like, a thumbs up, and subscribe. Like I said, I upload every single Tuesday and Friday. If you have video recommendations, let me know. I'll pop my Instagram here, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. My body never known.